Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name's David and this is a top 10. Hey, today we're gonna look at the top 10 decks from Theory 11. A lot of people have been asking for these top 10 lists, saying they like it. They say, give us more top 10 lists. And then whenever people comment and say which top 10 list they want, the most of you have been asking for Theory 11, so here it is, Theory 11. Hey, if you don't know Theory 11, Theory 11 launched back in 2007 with a team of 11 artists united with one purpose in mind, and that was to advance, inspire, and create wonder. And since that moment, Theory 11 has propelled forward to become the largest community of magic creators with over 1,500 registered artists and hundreds of thousands of members around the world. All right, so top 10 decks, top 10 Theory 11 decks, let's go. Number 10, the Bicycle Titanium. I know this seems like a weird one, but I don't know that people know that this is out here. It's a quality rider back. It's the back design, the box, and even the court cards that you are familiar with, but they utilize a metallic ink that radiates light in a really subtle and elegant manner. The box has metallic foil on five sides, showcasing the original rider back design that you know and love. It's available in two colors, steel blue and crimson red. The Bicycle Titanium Edition playing cards were printed from the United States Playing Card Company using the finest quality stock and finish. They feel smooth, they're not too rigid, right out of the box. Number 9, the Monarchs. Monarchs were featured throughout the blockbuster heist movie, Now You See Me, alongside Jesse Eisenberg, Mark Ruffalo, Woody Harrelson. They also made a reappearance in the sequel. They look like they belong in a palace. You got gold foil. It all surrounds the elegant navy blue box design. Gold metallic foil is striking with a vintage, timeless aesthetic. They're absolutely breathtaking, and they feel as good as they look. Number 8, the Rebels. Rebel playing cards feature a custom designed box, back design, Ace of Spades, Joker. The back design proudly features the United States Capitol building. It's a timeless symbol of our nation's united spirit of independence. For the first time in 50 years, Rebels features a die-cut tax stamp seal with frayed edges. Across the card backs, you have the Latin phrase, light in darkness. Number 7, the Rare Bits. This deck features metallic ink. I have the copper one here. You got that on the back and faces, all custom court cards, elegant, simple design by Jay Fletcher in Charleston, South Carolina. Inspired by a vintage speakeasy restaurant called the Rare Bit, which is also in Charleston. The Rare Bit playing cards became an instant collector's item when they were released back in 2013. Even the first edition sold out record-shattering 16 hours, and right now on eBay, they go for about $200. Number 6, the Artisan. This deck was featured in Departures magazine. Artisans have received rave reviews around the world. David Copperfield called them the best playing cards ever produced. They're illustrated by hand in South Africa. Artisans are in a league of their own, a breathtaking mix of elegance, style, and sophistication. Designed by Simon Frowes, these premium luxury playing cards feature elegant gold foil hot stamped on ultra luxe black paper. Number 5, the Tycoon. This is a premium designer playing card produced in collaboration with Steve Cohen, who's the Millionaire's Magician. He's the star of Chamber Magic, which is a headline show out in New York. And this deck was originally inspired by the Waldorf Astoria, which was a legendary gathering place for royalty and the ultra wealthy. No expense was spared for this new edition. These you're looking at are the Ivory Edition Tycoons, which are enclosed in an off-white premium tuck case, shielded in gold foil, and the card back design is printed with a gold metallic ink. Number 4, the Citizens. I think these are the most intricate, breathtaking playing cards ever produced. Illustrated in America by Kevin Cantrell, every aspect was handcrafted with relentless, unrivaled attention to detail. Even the inside of the box has a breathtaking, intricate pattern. The Joker, back design, they all bear the Latin phrase, fortune favors the brave. Number 3, Medallions. A blend of sheer elegance and striking beauty, a timeless object infused with supreme luxury from the Victorian era. The design is accented by embossed stitch elements in the front and sealed with the signature precision printed gold foil sticker seal. They were designed in Paris, France. Number 2, the Nomad playing cards. These were produced in collaboration with the Nomad Hotel in New York City. Back in the 19th century, the Nomad District of New York was the meeting place of all of that era's elite, featuring Oscar Wilde, Charles Dickens, Mark Twain, Tesla. The vision for this deck was to create cards that would serve as a monument to the Nomad Hotel. And I think the result is a timeless blend of beauty and elegance. And number one, Contraband, designed in the United Kingdom by Joe White. Contraband playing cards were inspired by secret societies, conspiracy theories, and everything unknown. Every single playing card within the Contraband deck was designed from scratch. Even the aces, jokers, court cards, they display attention to detail never before achieved. Over a year in the making, and every minute of it is visible in the final design. All right, so that is my top 10 Theory 11 decks. Did I miss one? Did I miss your favorite? Did you think, wow, what the heck? Why did you put that at number 8 and not at number 3? Tell us below. Tell us which decks are your favorite. If I missed one, if you have another favorite, let us know. I do try to answer all of your comments and questions, because why else would you have a YouTube channel if you weren't going to answer your fans, right? Come on. I'll try to do more of these top 10s in the future. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.